Welcome to the newest addition to the show. Cover two analysts, former state champion Kaiser head coach Rich Miano and coach fourth-ranked Kahuku improved to 4-0 with a 78-0 win over McKinley last week. They're allowing 2 points per game, negative yards rushing. How terrifying is that Red CD?
It's frightening, and it's still early in the 2015 season, but think back to 2014 when they didn't give up a touchdown to Punahou's vaunted offense. But it's a little bit different now because Vai Tata, who's now the head coach, is also the defensive coordinator, and he's learned under Dick LeBeau. I mean, that guy's a genius, David Shaw at Stanford, and he's running this program like a college, and I think that's going to resonate in the classroom and in the community. Talk about it on D-line. I mean, they're coached by Matt Fungo, who's a terrific coach, but Samson Reed, the sophomore, had 4 sacks. You got Bradley Anai, defensive backs, Coach Kial Santiago and his son. So you've just got a phenomenal, you could list all 11 of those guys, and they all can play football.
Well, Kahuku and fellow top five squads St. Louis and Kamehameha idle this week. The top dog Trojans, though, on the slate in this week's marquee matchup. And that's where on the ninth island, the defending state champs will look to bring back much more than a suitcase filled with goodies from Trader Joe's. 1 week after the boys of Kalaipohaku snatched a 27-point victory over the Patriots, Trojans will look for a 17th straight victory and will no doubt attempt to do it on the arm of senior quarterback Mackenzie Milton. In 3 games, number 13 already with 859 yards passing, 12 touchdowns and just 1 interception. While Nevada's second-ranked Pats bring a whole lot of aloha with a total of 6 Hawaii-born coaches on staff, including former Roosevelt and University of Hawaii star offensive coordinator Chad Kapanui.
I see what Rotham doing. I mean, that's just awesome for the kids and, you know, for the community. But yeah, I mean, Rotham is doing a good job, and it starts with coaching. For sure, and obviously when you got some great talented kids and you got a good quarterback like that, you know, it's they can put up some numbers for sure. So I mean, yeah, we're excited to even get to play them.
You know, we play for bigger, better things other than our football team. You know, we represent our community, and you know, with this trip we represent the state of Hawaii.
How much of a benefit was it to watch Liberty play against St. Louis? I mean, not too many times you get to play a team from the continent and get to scout them the week before.
Yeah, you know, definitely anytime you can scout them, it's great, and not to mention we already played St. Louis, so we can kind of compare and see, you know, how we would probably match up. But, you know, you're not going to know until you go game day.
Of course, Trojans not just a passing threat with Milton and fellow UH commit Kalakaua Timoteo. Oregon-bound running back Vavai Malapeai untouchable thus far, averaging 7 yards per carry with 7 touchdowns in 2015. So, Coach, interesting setup with the number one ranked squad facing a team that was steamrolled by the number two team. Do you think Mililani has to try and avoid concentrating on beating Liberty and not trying to beat the performance the Crusaders put forth a week ago?
Yeah, because these comparisons are inevitable because these are the two best teams. And when you talk about these two teams, you mentioned you got to start at the top. Mackenzie Milton and both Tua Tagovailoa, the two best quarterbacks in the state. Then you go down to the wide receivers and you talk about Kalakaua Timoteo and Drew Kobayashi from St. Louis. Those are two of the top receivers in the state. And then at running back, Vavai Malapeai and Jared Silufau. Those guys can play as well, but they also have great defenses this year. They also are coached well. Special teams are playing well. So unless Kahuku, unless Punahou, or unless Kamehameha has something to say about this, those could be the state guys in the finals.
On the other sideline, the aforementioned Chad Kapanui running the offense for Liberty. He played for you at UH. Did you see the coaching DNA in him when he was rocking the number 5 in green and white right there? Look at that.
Yeah, he looks good in the green and white. There's no question about that. But you saw the enthusiasm. You saw the versatility. He played multiple positions. Came to us as a quarterback. Ended up playing running back, linebacker, special teams. And he also brought along his little friend, Mighty Mouse, Chad Owens. So that was kind of a 2-for-1 package. But it's so admirable to do what he's doing. Because if he was in the state of Hawaii, he'd be coaching high school football. But unfortunately for us, he's in Nevada, but he's still working with the youth. And there's plenty of Paulies in Nevada, so he's doing a great job.
And he's doing a great job up there. Liberty, a fantastic program. Well, this time, Coach Copps and his Pats get an elite 808 squad on their own home turf, though. Mililani playing in the school's first ever game away from the islands. Kickoff set for Friday, 4 p.m. Hawaii time. We'll keep you posted on the score at KHON2.com. All right, we're flying high here on Cover 2. Time to take a quick timeout. When we come back, Punahou gets peppered on this week's pop quiz A trio of OIA squads look to remain unbeaten in league play. Plus, Sam Spangler takes us on campus to the second city of Kapolei.
Hey, what's up, everybody? You know, being that it's about to be the first day of school here on campus, you know we had to pick out our outfit the night beforehand. Stay tuned after the break. We're headed out west to lace up our Sunday best. You're watching Cover 2.